Hello, everybody. I'm Howling Nightman, and welcome back to Let's Play Civilization 3 as the Hittites. When we last left off, I had started a war with the Indians down here, not Native Americans, but Indians, as in ones people who come from India, led by their warmonger Gandhi. And, it didn't end so well with me. He destroyed one of my bigger towns right here. And then these guys over here, red guys, I'm not sure who they are, although they might be French. No. Maybe they're Greeks. They found a city there, so I don't particularly feel like going to war against them, so I don't particularly want to screw around with them and fight them. So, anyway, I've been doing some thinking since we left off, and, well, I'd like to take a look over here at the victory status screen. The victory status screen basically shows, like, how many culture you have, but basically the how close people are to winning through various methods. And right now I seem to be the highest with the best chance of winning, considering I have the highest score, which means that once 2050 comes around, whoever has the highest score wins automatically. Though it's kind of just the cheapest way to win, really. And I've also got the most culture, and I control the largest area of the largest area of the world, and also control the most people. Now, I've been thinking since the last game, and I've decided I am going to try and fully colonize this area over here. If I stick a city right here, 1, 2, stick a city right here. And I could put another one right here. Maybe stick one right. Well, 1, 2. If I stick one right here. So that means I could put a total of 3 more cities over here. Which is what I'm going to try and do, actually. So, oh, these guys. Do I have any galleys about? I'm just wondering, because I kind of just want to remove these jerkwads from my borders. It looks like I might not. I don't have any boats. That's kind of depressing. I'll need to rectify that soon. You can do it. I want you actually to build a caravel. And you are going to actually hurry production of that. I want it to be done next turn. Good. You've built a caravel. Now Kara will take out these jerkwads. Come on, kill them! I've turned down the volume on the sound, so hopefully that will help with the audio bit. Oh, finished Copernicus University. Now you should build a settler. Come on. Yes! That's good. Okay, built an aqueduct here. I'd like you to build a, I would say a, granary. Granaries, they vary in usefulness. A lot of the time in the early game, they are very useful, but this late stage in the game, not nearly as much. Oh, that's one of mine, and, oh, that's Indian. You are going to go over here. Theory of gravity. Alright. Oh yeah. Gotta fix these guys' civil disorder. It hurts me, but I'll have to do that. And you will change. I'm not sure a marketplace will really help. I guess a cathedral. Oh, fudging, come on. That is just. And you're probably gonna place it in such a place where it'll get a lot harder. Let's see. What does it look like? Oh, you're gonna place it right friggin' there. Ugh, I hate you, jerkwads. Someone is going to get their ass eat. Pardon my French. You know what? It's decided. I am going to go to war before this game is done. I am going to go to war with these guys and wipe them out. This will not be tolerated, what they are doing. Okay, yeah, but you go stay there. And then you, I want you to go here. And you shall explore the world, I guess. Yes. Yes. Ha! I've got an elite caravel now. Oh. Probably would rather have it there. Ooh. Recent technological breakthrough. If I'm not mistaken, that means I'm also going to be getting a new settler, or not settler, a great scientist. All right. Yeah. Hurry, city production. I'd say that one. There, at least it'll prevent him from founding another city over here. Now I'm gonna want you to build a temple. I'm gonna hurry that. Now, build a lighthouse. And, elite warrior, you go over here. Ugh. Production. And then afterwards, I want you to build a. Arbor. Sorry about that. Now, it's good that these guys, their culture expanded. I'm just gonna hurry this too. I've got money. And, well, that's what money's main use for, especially as a civilization like this. Now that you've done that, I want you to build next a courthouse to reduce corruption. A good culture expanded there. Let's take a look and see. I've gone up in relative world area, I think, but I've gone down a little in world population, and that will have to be rectified. Although, yeah. Oh, good. We are now in the industrial age. Which means. Oh, good. I can expand my palace. Let's see. I did. So that means I. Let's see. So if I did that, then I'm going to do. Yeah. Does this place have an aqueduct? Yeah, it does. It'd be kind of silly if I didn't make use of it. Oh, I can't make use of it. That's kind of silly. Let's see here. You. Yeah. Yeah, hurry that. All right, now build a aqueduct. You built a courthouse, that's good. I would say, wait, what's the food situation look like? Oh, okay, in that case, build an arbor. Arbors can be very useful, especially with places like this. You can put a city in the desert, and normally they'd be starving for food, but if you put them in the desert by the sea and then have an arbor, then they can build up a pretty good population. Build a bank. Now, you should build a. Wait, you focus entirely on production, on population at this point. Darn it, I don't have many luxuries. I have been practicing quite a bit in between videos, which is kind of would be what you would hope for, considering I only update every Sunday at best. So I've been learning a bit more. Like, for instance, if you've got a really young world like this, usually there aren't as many luxury resources, and there's usually not as many luxury resources, and strategic resources, which can get quite frustrating. Oh, good. Oh, excuse me for a moment. Sorry about that, folks. I had to take a call. But anyway, let's go back to these. My people want to upgrade my palace again. Yay, I'm going to go with the European look over here. So, I like to have every ethnicity in here. So, because, I mean, certain things look better in certain positions than others. Like, I happen to quite like the European designs on the sides, but I prefer the Oriental design as like the sort of base area here. So let's see here. Don't I have anything to do? Oh, good. I've completed the Colossus, which it's like 1810. Just finished the Colossus, guys. Isn't this like the most bestest thing ever? Mean, it's gonna be obsoleted by flight. Hopefully that won't come for too long. But just now completing it. I'd actually say build a worker. I need more workers. Oh, good. Cultural influence expanding. You can take other people's colonies by overpowering them with culture. So having cultural wars like this, especially ones where they've just got the surrounding tiles on their city, and I've got a 3 range. But once these guys go up, oh man, it's gonna be so good. Oh, what do the English want to say? Metallurgy, no. Gonna give you metallurgy. Build marketplace. If I had more luxuries, I could show something. Basically, normally with each luxury, having one each luck different type of luxury you would have would provide one happiness. So, like for instance, I've got spices, so I get one happiness from that. Even if you have, I believe there are 8 different ones. If you have all 8 of those, you still Each one only provides one happiness. However, if you had a marketplace, the first two would only provide one, sure, but then the next two would provide two each, and then the next two after that would provide three each, and the next two after that would provide four each. Exponential bonus. Oh, culture is expanding. Oh, great lighthouse. Yeah, if you're such an advanced people. Oh, good, I can go for communism now. Oh, cultural influence is expanding. If I'm lucky over here, I'll start to culturally overtake some of the cities over here. Yep, I'm really putting the squeeze on this place here. Now, I prefer the area I had in before, but having that city there would be better than nothing. Let's see, can I change production to anything useful? Oh, yeah. I can change it to this. That would be good. Let it complete the harbor. Oh, they want to expand my polish yet again. Let's see here. What was it I did? Oh, yeah. Greek on this side. All right, you. Oh, good. New Dawn's University. That means I get plus 50% science. And considering I have Copernicus' observatory, that means that I am going to get. That's 50% science there. Or, no, double scientific research, sorry. And then New Dawn's University also doubles it. So I've got. Quadruple, I believe. And you should build a university. Extra science is good. Oh, that's good too. Putting the cultural oppression on the stupid Indians. I don't know. No offense to people who actually live in India. I'm just talking about the Indians in this game. I happen to like India quite a lot. This is one of my favorite subcontinents. I'll just fortify there for now. Military tradition. No. No communism. Oop, wait, did I just? Oh yeah, I'm putting the cultural squeeze. That tile there used to be theirs, but now it's mine. Ooh, Forbidden Palace. That's going to really cut down on corruption, and it raises the amount of cities you can normally have. Like I probably used to have a lot more corruption there, but now I have a lot less. And then here, see. Ooh, marketplace. Build a. Oh yeah, now I remember those. Yeah, build a Colosseum. That will provide a little bit of culture, which hopefully will put some. Ooh, steam power. That will hopefully just squeeze them more and more. Cathedral. All right. Now build it. Do you have an arbor? All right. At this point, I would say go for a worker. You've produced a bank. Now produce. Wait, how much is corruption here? All right, I'll go with it. He looks like he's being forced to be happy. I mean, and these people do. These guys look like they're content, but these guys, they look like they're, or girls rather. They kind of look like they're, well, under the influence of one or more narcotics, which kind of could be explained by the fact that I've got spice. But okay, you go to university, you can now build a marketplace. Yeah, a marketplace would be used. Oh, more culture for me. Marketplace. An arbor. All right, go with an aqueduct now. Yeah, my culture is really starting to put the squeeze on people. I mean, let's take a look and see. Oh. You think I'm idiots? My area is not vulnerable to attack. If anything, yours is. Now let's take a look and see how much land I have in the population. Okay, good. Population's gone up. World area's gone up. Current score has gone up. And I'm halfway there with my capital, and a third of the way there with my entire civilization. Alright. Marketplace, that's good. Build a Colosseum. Alright. Oh, good. Cathedral here. And, build a police station. Oh, wait. Do you have an aqueduct? Oh, then you should build a harbor. More population is better. Alright, industrialization. No, I don't want fascism. Fascism and communism are only good if you're in a very militarily focused civilization, especially one that is... Well, it depends. I mean, communism's better for big, sprawling civilizations because every city has the same amount of corruption, but it's very low. Fascism, you basically, if you've got like a few core cities, it's good. But those outlying cities are just gonna have jacks squat. Let's see how much does, yeah, not much, so not much use building a that there, so build a bank, I guess. Did they take it back? I think they did. Yeah. They're starting to build up culture there themselves. That does not make me happy. This place, 63 per turn, that is good. And you... Yeah, sure, go for a privateer. Alright, corporation, go for it. Wait, did their borders just expand down here? Oh, it's these guys, these orange guys. Delhi has completed that. Well, you, my friend, are going to go over here. Are there any that only have one access to water? Oh, good, this one. Go right there. Looks to be one of their slightly bigger seas, too. Alright, so you are going to produce universal suffrage. And you are now producing... refining, that sounds good. Oh, Smith's Train Company. This reduces... well... basically, you don't have to pay for maintenance costs for a lot of your... a lot of the, money. Well, basically a lot of your, well, as they put, trade-based city improvements. So... I wonder what the historical significance behind Smith's Train Company is. Well, I want you to now... wait. Ooh, factory. Yeah, you're gonna need a factory. Oh, they want to expand the house. Okay, that'll be do. And, yeah, I think that's it for this episode. Thank you everyone for watching this, and I hope you continue to watch my episodes. I know they're not the best, but I try. And, I'm Howling Nightman. And I'm Howling Nightman, and this is Howling Nightman signing off.